Because
go on.
The video can be used for future use. That means if you are not opportune to get the lesson today, you can go through the videos. The videos will also be used. And you can use it for generation, those that are yet to come. With these videos, we all actually benefit them. I decided to bring the videos in as much as possible. Most of the teachings online will not be repeated. Whatever that we do will not be repeted, but the videos will now be serving that particular purpose. That means you can listen at ease, or even those who are opportune to have the smartphone, because the online teaching actually needs smartphone. But if you're not fortunate to get a smartphone, you cannot make use of the online, the videos. The videos will help you a lot to get all the basic things that we are done. Now, in today's online teaching through the Zoom, we looked at basic areas. There are topics that actually create problems for those who are taking the WAS exams, and these particular topics cut across for first year and some major areas in the sciences, second year as well. So in as much as possible, you are able to grab a concept where you can use this not only for the WAS exam, but for first year and second year. And the topics we actually put together, we have about 8 major topics in the physical chemistry. And the 8 major topics were now put according to levels, depending on those who will be taking the exams. Because whatever we are doing now is to cater for them first. Whatever knowledge they might have learned or gained from that level will now be used to further their education. That means they can use that now when they are first year or second year. In as much as possible, I tried my level best to solve the basic things that these people need. I now look at the most difficult ones. These are areas that are not easily taught. And as much as possible, you are able to go through these topics, your chemistry will be okay. Because today we started the online teaching with chemistry. And the first and the most important, which happens to be the most difficult topics in the physical chemistry, was what we started with. And we went 80% of that. For the benefit of those who are not online, you can also gain that as well. Today we started oxidation and reduction, which happens to be one of the most critical areas for those who will be taking the exams. So we started with oxidation and reduction for today's class. We started that. And in as much as the chemistry is concerned, there are the basic things to be done under this oxidation and reduction will be: one, how will you be able to get basic terms? How can you define the basic terms involved? After which, how will you be able to use these terms we have read or learned already to balance some basic equations? That ends the analysis. But we are now looking at this thing to some perspective here. Whatever way you look at, somebody will not just say you define oxidation, you go ahead to write. There are basic things the examiners or whosoever will require or deem necessary for you to put in the definition. And if we are now looking at these things, we'll make use of 4 definitions for each. We'll be making use of 4 definitions for oxidation, we'll make use of 4 definitions for reduction, after which we'll make use of 4 definitions for oxidation, oxidizing agent, we'll make use of 4 definitions for reducing agent. I go over that. There are 4 definitions for oxidation, 4 definitions for reduction, 4 definitions for oxidizing agent, 4 definitions for reducing agent. If you can now put 4 by 4, that will give you 16 definitions. So there are basically 16 definitions we are going to handle as far as this topic is concerned. If you are able to grab all the 16 definitions, you put that under control, you can go ahead to solve any questions wherever you are, and to whosoever you want to explain. And if that is the case, I now rest your case that the 16 definitions will not bother you much. Because what I will do is for you just to understand 4 definitions out of the 16. If you are able to understand 4 definitions out of the 16, I will negate. When I negate, that means when I change the meaning of the 4 definitions, I will get another 4 definitions. That will be a total of 8. When I now again interchange the 8 definitions, 8 multiplied by 2 will give me a total of 16. Then it starts. We are starting with the first one, which is oxidation. You have the right now to say oxidation is defined as. Now, one of the 4 definitions I said, oxidation is defined as 1. The addition or gain of oxygen. Addition or gain of oxygen is defined as oxidation. To define oxidation, one of the ways we can define oxidation is by the addition or the gain of oxygen. What do we mean by that? That any element that gains oxygen, or any element you add oxygen to, that element is oxidized. The moment you add oxygen to a particular element or a substance, that element or substance is oxidized. If I have carbon, for example, I add oxygen to that, to give a carbon through oxide this way. The CO carbon is combining with oxygen to produce that carbon through oxide. So in as much as possible, I have added oxygen to the carbon. I say that is oxidation because I have added oxygen to that compound. So anytime you add oxygen to a compound, you call that oxidation. The second definition we make use of for the oxidation is the removal of hydrogen. Loss of hydrogen. That means anytime an element or a species loses or you remove hydrogen from that element or species, you say that particular species is oxidized. Anytime a particular element loses hydrogen, that particular element is oxidized. I will look at an example in which if we now have hydrogen sulfide H2S, you add chlorine to that, depending on the reactivity, what will now happen is chlorine will replace wherever sulfur is. You are going to have HCl instead of sulfur, chlorine is taking the place of that sulfur. And the sulfur itself is now liberated at that particular point. Sulfur is produced on the right-hand side, that means on the product side. If I want, I will try to balance the equation by putting two in front here, two in front of that. I have two hydrogen here, two hydrogen. Now let us look at the definition. The removal or loss of hydrogen. When you come here, you have H2S, hydrogen sulfide. There was hydrogen attached to the sulfur. But when you now come to sulfur on the right-hand side, the hydrogen was removed. Here we are having H2S, that means hydrogen was attached. But when you are now at this point, there is no hydrogen. That means sulfur has lost hydrogen. They have removed hydrogen from sulfur. If you remove hydrogen from sulfur, you call that oxidation. That is another way you can define oxidation. The third definition you can advance for oxidation is, oxidation is also defined as loss of electron. Oxidation is defined as loss of electron. That means anytime an element loses an electron, that element is said to be oxidized. The moment you remove an electron from an element, that element is said to be oxidized. I have, for instance, sodium. The valency for sodium is 1. So the valency for sodium, since it is 1, sodium loses. Minus means we are removing the electron. We remove one electron from sodium, and when a particular element loses an electron, becomes positively charged. You have Na positive. Since it is losing one electron, that is why you are having plus 1 here. If it is magnesium that you have, magnesium has a valency of 2. Magnesium loses the 2 electrons, and you have Mg2 positive. Because it loses 2 electrons here, that is why you are having 2 plus. So anytime an element loses an electron, you call that oxidation. The last definition you can advance is, oxidation is also defined as increase in oxidation number. It is defined as increase in oxidation number. Oxidation is defined as the increase in oxidation number. So anytime the oxidation number of an element increases, that element is said to be oxidized. For example, the example I cited here, I said magnesium losing 2 electrons to give us Mg2 positive. When you look at the oxidation number of this species, here is no value here. That means the oxidation number here is 0, and it has moved from 0 to 2. So if you move from 0 to 2, we call that increase. The value has increased because we have moved from 0 to 2. If you come to this species here, it is moving from 0 to 1. So that is still oxidation. The moment there is an increase in the oxidation number of the element, the number here increases from 0 to 2. Here it increases from 0 to 1. That is oxidation. So out of the 16 definitions I said you should know, I have gone through 4. One is the addition or the gain of oxygen. Anytime the element, you add oxygen to that element, you say it is oxidized. The second phase is, we said the removal or loss of hydrogen. That means anytime you remove hydrogen from an element, you call that reaction oxidation reaction. Anytime again the element loses an electron, loss of electron, you call that oxidation. Again, when you increase the oxidation number, you call that oxidation as well. In as much as possible, you are able to understand the 4 definitions, you can get the remaining 12 definitions from the 4. Because the remaining 12 definitions that we are to get will all move from here. And if you want to get that, we make use of our words with their opposites. Whatever that we have discussed here, the opposite of that will go for reduction. So whatever that is true for oxidation, when you change that, becomes now reduction. So it takes us now to reduction. We have the right to define reduction now as, we can say reduction is defined as, one of the ways we can define reduction is when we now change the meaning Here for oxidation, we say the addition or gain of oxygen. So if we are under reduction, instead of the addition, the opposite of addition or gain of oxygen will be the remover or loss of oxygen. Here we can say the remover or loss of oxygen. So we can define reduction as the opposite of oxidation. Oxidation was the addition or the gain of oxygen. So the reduction now becomes the remover or loss of oxygen. So the opposite of oxidation is even loss reduction. Anytime the element loses or you remove, or the element loses an oxygen, you call that reduction reaction. So the oxygen is lost, or you remove oxygen from a particular species. I will write a particular reaction. In this case, we have the right to make use of copper oxide or copper two oxide. If you react that with hydrogen, you are going to get a particular species in which the oxygen from here removed. When the oxygen moves from here, it is coming to oxygen. So the oxygen is moving, the oxygen moves to the hydrogen here. You get water. When hydrogen and oxygen they combine, because you get water. And the copper here is degraded at this point. So that becomes oxidation. Why? There was oxygen attached to copper. But now when you look at this copper here, there is no oxygen. That means copper has lost oxygen, or somebody removed oxygen from copper. That becomes reduction. The second one is when we also change the other definition, we change the meaning of number two here. For number two, under oxidation, we say the remover or loss of hydrogen. So if you are not looking at remover, the opposite of remover will be the gain or the addition of hydrogen. So when you are here, the opposite for the definition under oxidation becomes here now as the gain or addition of hydrogen. The gain or addition of hydrogen. So anytime you add hydrogen to a particular species, you say that species is reduced. We can look at the Haber process reaction in which nitrogen will react with hydrogen. When nitrogen reacts with hydrogen, whether it is under the equilibrium reaction, whatever you want to, nitrogen reacting with hydrogen to produce ammonia, NH3. I can balance the reaction by putting two in front of this. I put three in front. What has happened to nitrogen here? Somebody has added hydrogen to nitrogen. We have added hydrogen to nitrogen. So we call that reduction reaction. We now have the right to say nitrogen is reduced. Why? Because we have added hydrogen to nitrogen. So that reaction becomes reduction reaction. We go to number three, which will be the opposite of the definition, the third definition under oxidation. The third definition under oxidation says loss of electron. So when you now want to change loss of electron, you can now here have the right to say the gain of electron. Gain of electron. Under oxidation, we said oxidation was the loss of electron. So the opposite of loss will now go under reduction. So that becomes the gain of electron. Anytime you add an electron to a particular species, you have reduced that species. We have the right to say chlorine, if we have chlorine now gaining an electron here. When you gain, you become negatively charged. Have in mind, here we